menopause is a very important stage in a woman's life, and it's very important that you are aware of how to tackle these problems that can arise during menopause. First of all, let me start with the definition of menopause. Menopause is that period when you do not have your menstrual cycle for a total of 12 months or 1 year. So if you've not had a period for one whole year, it means you have reached menopause. But as important as menopause is something called the perimenopausal period. That is the period during menopause. Usually it's about 2 years before and maybe 2 years after. So the two years before menopause is the perimenopausal period, and it is a period of transition from having regular cycles to menopause. We'll come to it shortly. Now, the age of menopause, it's anywhere between 42 to 45 or even 52 years. So this is a wide range, and it depends on many factors. One of them is also genetic. So we usually ask the patient at what age the mother or the grandmother or the sister or the aunt had their menopause, and roughly this woman also would have a menopause around that age. But it's very important to note, if somebody has stopped their periods less than 40 years of age, it's not normal menopause. It's premature menopause and needs to be investigated. So the menopause, now we know what is menopause if someone stops their period for one whole year. Why should a woman have menopause? This is a very often question that patients ask me. Why should you have menopause? There's a very interesting fact that you need to know. As women, we are born with all the eggs that we can ever produce in our lives. In other words, if a baby, girl baby is born, at birth, she will have around 1 million eggs between the two ovaries. There are two ovaries, so 1 million eggs. That is 10 lakh eggs. These eggs go on dying. A process called apoptosis. They go on dying every month, every year, to such an extent that by the time she attains menarche or her first period, there are only about 40,000 eggs in both the ovaries. So it was 10 lakhs, and now it's come to 40,000. Again, during her reproductive period, that is from about 13 years up to 43, 45 years till she has menopause, she produces the eggs. There's no new egg that is produced. Whatever eggs are there, every cycle, about 5 eggs develop, out of which one really ripens and ruptures. All the other 4 die. Also, continuously eggs keep dying throughout her reproductive period to such an extent by the time she is 43 or 45, there are no more eggs left in the ovary. That is, the storage is now empty. So there are no more eggs. So no more eggs are produced, and therefore the woman stops her periods. So whenever one egg is produced, there is the production of two important hormones, the estrogen and also the progesterone. So it follows that whenever no eggs are produced, then there is no periods, and therefore the hormone levels are also reduced. So this comes to the next point. This takes us to the next important point. Why are the symptoms occurring during menopause? This is mainly because of lack of these hormones, that is estrogen. As I told you, estrogen is the hormone that is secreted by the ovaries, and lack of estrogen causes all the symptoms that we see in menopause. Now, the symptoms of menopause can be broadly classified as physical and also mental symptoms. Physically, you may experience hot flushes. Suddenly, you may feel hot, chest upwards, and you may start sweating. That is because of the release of hormones from the brain. So this usually lasts for about 6 months to 2 years. Either it could be during the perimenopausal period or even after the menopause. And it is not compulsory that all women should have hot flushes during the perimenopause or menopause. And secondly, and most importantly, menstrual irregularities. Menstrual irregularities, as I told you, there is a reduction in the number of eggs, and finally the eggs that are produced will stop. So there is a reduction in the estrogen, therefore the reduction in the functions. So it follows that your menstrual cycle should gradually reduce and then finally stop. In other words, if you were getting periods once every 30 days, lasting for about 4 to 5 days, gradually you may start getting your periods once in 45 to 50 days, lasting for about 1 to 2 days, and finally it will stop. So this is the normal way how the periods should stop. If anything beyond this, like if you have heavy periods, or if you have periods once in 15 days, or if you are continuously spotting, it is not menopause. There are many people who might tell you that because you are approaching menopause, your periods have become heavy or they have become irregular. But please don't ignore irregular periods during the period of menopause. Then there are two more important things that occur because of reduced estrogen. That is the effect on bone and the effect on the heart. See, the estrogens are very important to maintain the bone strength. So as the estrogens are reduced, the bones undergo a weakness. Like in our medical terms, we call it as osteoporosis. So the bones become more brittle, I would say. So, and they are more prone for breaking. That is why you see older women who fall down, they can break their bones easily. This is because of the lack of estrogen. And estrogen is also responsible for protecting our heart. So you can see that the incidence of heart attacks is more in men than in women, especially up to 55 to 60 years. After that, the incidence of heart attack is the same in men as well as in the women. So the estrogen has got a protective action against the heart. Also, estrogen has a protective action against the local genitalia, whether it is the vulva or the vagina. So withdrawal or reduced estrogen will cause dryness and itching and also urinary symptoms, which are all attributed to lack of estrogen. And another thing that happens during menopause, not because of menopause, but because of the timing of menopause, 45 to 52 years. So this is the time around which women may develop hypertension or diabetes, and even more importantly, the cancer may show its face for the first time during this period. So we should be alert about this condition also. Another problem is the mental issues during the time of menopause. Number one, it could be attributed to lack of estrogen, because that causes, it may cause forgetfulness, it may cause anxiety, it may cause sleeplessness. But all symptoms cannot be attributed to lack of estrogen. Like there may be emotional lability, there may be anger outbursts. This is all because of other social conditions that happen during the time of menopause in a woman's life. For example, this woman has been caring for her children, for her husband all her lives, and now when she's 45 or so, the children have grown up and they've gone out to either study or they've gone out to work, and suddenly she finds herself alone, empty in the house. This has got a very touching phrase in English that is known as empty nest syndrome. It's just like a bird lays its egg in the nest, and then the birdlings, when once they are able to fly away, they leave the nest empty and the mother bird is feeling lonely. So the same thing happens during the period of menopause, and this is very important because the people around her, her children and her husband, should recognize this, that yes, my mother is feeling lonely, and top of it, she is having this period of menopause where there is reduced estrogen, and that is why it is causing all these mental symptoms. So such women, with they need support from the family, and believe me, it's not going to be forever. It's going to be during the period of perimenopause and menopause, and they'll bounce back to normal maybe in the next 6 months or 1 year, and they need all your support. So these are the symptoms, mental as well as the physical symptoms of menopause. And now I'll give you a few tips as to how you can tackle this problem of estrogen deficiency. Is there anything in your diet that can make up for the estrogen deficiency? Yes, to some extent. Soya is found to contain phytoestrogens that might help you to reduce your hot flushes. So we often advise using soya flour along with your wheat or atta. Maybe fistful of soya flour into 1 kg would be sufficient. Then you have the soya nuggets which you can be using it. So these are phytoestrogens, and sometimes these come as capsules also, and if your doctor thinks that it is necessary, you may take those soya isoflavones that come as capsules. Now this is about the estrogen deficiency, how you can combat. But then I told you osteoporosis, using soya will not help osteoporosis. You need other things to keep osteoporosis at bay, and that includes supplemental calcium. So calcium is one thing which can help in osteoporosis, and it's not that, see, for women it's not that only at 42 correctly or at 45 suddenly they start having osteoporosis. It's a gradual process, and it is found that it starts somewhere around 35 years itself, the bones start becoming weak. So you're advised to take calcium supplements even at when you are 40. The third thing is just calcium supplementation will not, and diet, of course. Diet is also important, which contains calcium, like ragi and milk products. You can use skim milk if you are scared of putting on weight. So this slight change in the diet to foods containing calcium might also help. But most importantly, exercises. You need to build your bones strong by doing some physical activity. So exercises, diet rich in calcium, and calcium supplementation might see you through osteoporosis. Now the next factor is of course cardiac protection, and here you have to have a lifestyle modification. So people at menopause tend to put on weight because their basal metabolic rate reduces, and therefore more of fat gets accumulated. So this also leads to hypertension and diabetes, and also problems with the heart. So reducing your weight by whatever methods, by proper diet, by taking balanced diet, by doing regular exercise, by avoiding the wrong foods, will go a long way in combating the risks due to reduced estrogen and effect on the heart. And finally, it's also important that you have to have a positive state of mind. Understand that menopause and menopausal symptoms are not going to last forever. Understand that you have another 35 or 45 years of life to live post-menopause. Understand that it is possible to combat all the symptoms by a change in the lifestyle and support from others. The family should be supportive, and you can have a peer group of similarly aged women who are supportive of each other, who are empowering each other, sharing notes and sharing positive thoughts. And also, finally, you can go and involve yourself. If you are not a working person, if you are a homemaker and suddenly find that your house is empty now, this is the time to pursue all the hobbies that you wanted to do. This is the time to draw, paint, or whatever you sing, or whatever you wanted to do. So use this time positively, keep your mind positively, and menopause. And remember, menopause is only one phase in your life. And when once you overcome this, and it's not a must that all women should experience all the symptoms that I have told you. So when once you are able to overcome this, you will sail through your menopause. And one last word about regular examination. As I told you, getting cancers is common as you age, and breast cancer is something that you should be on the lookout for, and you should learn how to do a self breast examination. Your doctor will teach you self breast examination every month, and you examine your breast yourself to look for any lump, and every year you can go in for a clinical breast examination, including all the ultrasound to see your uterus and also the ovaries, and then something called the liquid based cytology or the pap smear that is done to detect the cancer of the cervix. This we advise for all women after 25 years up to 50 years, and after 50 years you can go in for an LBC once every 5 years so that we can detect the cancer of your cervix, and then get your BP sugar checked, keep everything in check, and then you should be able to sail through menopause very easily and enjoy the rest of your life. Thank you.